Thank you. what, 90 and I got, oh, good stuff. Yeah, is that gonna do it? Yeah. Oh, they're both really late. It's not gonna get the edge guard, yeah. Alright, yeah. That was actually Blue's last lifeline, so really good that you got that one over there. Maybe I can see a reversal there. I didn't really see too much of the max. Yo, I don't even know what DSR is, man. I gotta make a little run. Lilat. I think it's decent, actually. Kind of decent. It's a lot of the Bowser's F tilt on down tilt. That's scary just because of the angle at which the Platts is at. So this might actually be a good choice. Yeah, definitely. Do you want to see how the stage plays into it? But more at war, Blue kind of does about it. Yeah, figuring out what he did well last game. So, oh, he's still not sure that was efficient. But yeah, definitely looking a little bit impressive. Snake is kind of hard to play against. I guess these platforms set up is pretty favorable. Blue having a hard time getting any significant hits out, and he's just gonna take the deep four with him and pretend like it's not even him. Big damage there, just have that narrative fair, and honestly just closes out the percent gap immediately. Really interesting ledge traps over here, kind of like the classic Snake, but I feel like Underdog mixes it up just a little bit sometimes and it catches people off guard. Gets the grab right off with a kind of like a decent off smash there. Grabs here. Maybe he would kill on 76. I don't know how. I feel like Lilat's blast zones are pretty close to the sides. Oh, he's gonna hit out of there. Not quite gonna kill Bowser, like all the way through 180. And the really good thing is that it's, I'm not able to fish out that that up B with those side Bs. But he's gonna get the kill anyway. And Underdog's looking at 76%. Pretty comfortable here. Definitely, I think the stage is kind of messing up the Blue's game. Lilat has a very interesting gap. This is not quite killed, but he's really got to watch out for that Z4. I think it's still there. Ooh, gets the light hit in here, and that's not going to kill. The forward tilt might come in handy because the Lilat just has to go for the C4. Yeah, really dicey situation. This will still not go well. Yeah, maybe looking for op airs or something of the sort. Trying to just end Underdog stock here. Definitely fishing for some backers and some really good hits. Using good spacing on the fair as well. And he uses the tomahawk grab, and that's going to get no kill, still really good DI by that living all with 170 there. Yeah, it's interesting. Even Snake, ooh, this is the point. But Snake making it look like he's in Bowser's weight class. And, Underdog being pretty tricky here. Good to get off the ledge here. That's a pretty hard thing to do with that many projectiles out. And Blue's really going to be looking for some damage. Yeah. Blue pretty back all the way. Yeah, 49% on Snake. Really want to kill the boys. Really interesting. Good stuff on Blue. I like that he's really making it tricky in his landing situations of what he's going to land with. The tomahawk grab is always a threat. And sure, it won't kill like ridiculously, especially on Snake. But it's really good damage and it's really good mix up because Snake can't really kill the boys. Very Blue-esque. He's playing kind of his pace down really low. Sort of just special cover and kind of make sure he only gets the right hits. He's not like flowcharty either. He's being decently unpredictable and reading a lot of Underdog's options defensively. Tries to go for the forward smash on the reading. Maybe he was expecting a dash attack or something. Definitely could close out the stock here with maybe backer not being able to shield the buildings quite as well as he wanted to. Underdog might run away with a little bit more percent than Blue's comfortable with. Pushing him 110 definitely kills him for Snake, and he's gonna pop too.